At the end of first week, the embryo is partially embedded into the endometrium of his or her mother, with a cavity ventral to the inner cell mass or embryo proper. The name of this cavity is blastocyst cavity. The trophoblast has been divided into two parts. The one that consists of no clear-cut boundaries with lots of nuclei embedded into it is called syncytiotrophoblast, while the other part that consists of clear-cut cellular boundaries is called cytotrophoblast. The inner cell mass or embryo proper, initially it is an amalgam of two different types of cells. These cells then rearrange themselves, and those cells that come to lie on the top or dorsal, they are tall columnar and high lying, they are called epiblast, and those that are low lying and they are low cuboidal, they are called hypoblast. The blastocyst cavity is then personalized by lining its wall with the hypoblast derived cells. This newly formed wall is called Husserl membrane, and as it happens, the blastocyst cavity is now called exocelomic cavity. And the exocelomic membrane or Husserl membrane is that wall of this cavity. Although there is no yolk in the exocelomic cavity of human embryo, but a structure analogous to this in bird's embryo actually contains yolk. So with that reference, it is also conventionally called as yolk sac, but it is called early primitive or primary yolk sac because there will be some changes in this yolk sac. Also, it is called early primary or primitive umbilical vesicle because it really gets incorporated into the umbilical cord. With that reference, the Husserl membrane is also called yolk sac membrane or yolk sac endoderm or umbilical vesicle membrane or umbilical vesicle endoderm. Then the central cells start undergoing degeneration and a cavity forms, and the cells lining this convert into plectin cell. Now the second cavity that is formed is called amniotic cavity, and the cells that are lining this cavity are called amnioblast, and this membrane is called amnion. The initial defect that was formed is closed by fibrin deposition and it is called fibrin coagulum. During the mid of second week, a new population of cells start arising between these two cavities and cytotrophoblast. It forms extraembryonic mesoderm. This extraembryonic mesoderm, it further grows and proliferates. Small cavities begin to form within the extraembryonic mesoderm, and some interconnected network of cavities also start to appear within the syncytiotrophoblast. These cavities within the extraembryonic mesoderm, they coalesce to form extraembryonic xylem. This membrane is also called chorion, and with that reference, extraembryonic xylem has got another name, that is chorionic cavity. Still, there is no cavitation at this point and it is called connecting stalk. With the formation of extraembryonic xylem or chorionic cavity, this extraembryonic mesoderm has been split into two parts. The part that lines from outside the yolk sac or umbilical vesicle is called extraembryonic supplanctopleuric mesoderm, and the remaining part, it is called extraembryonic somatopleuric mesoderm that lines the amnion as well as the cytotrophoblast. And the part of extraembryonic mesoderm that connects the embryo along with its two cavities to the chorion is called connecting stalk. And the cavities that were formed within the syncytiotrophoblast, they are called lacunae. The hypoblasts then start proliferating and form a new wall within the umbilical vesicle or yolk sac. This is like a smaller box nested inside a larger box. The remaining part of umbilical vesicle or yolk sac forms exocelomic cyst. And the yolk sac or umbilical vesicle is now called secondary or definitive yolk sac or umbilical vesicle. Blood starts flowing within this interconnected lacunar network from maternal arteriole to the maternal finiole, and this is called primitive uteroplacental circulation. Finally, finger-like projections arise from the cytotrophoblast, and these are called primary villi. Thank you so much for watching this video.